this one. In my talk, you know, you're still proposing a new proposal or something like that to for future works. I just introduced you a deep description of California framework around the Korean Peninsula. So far, we have a higher. So, I will first mention the Korean Peninsula and the surrounding seas in the northwestern Pacific subduction zone, and briefly introduce the tectonics of the seas, and finally, I will move to Sunny Island. Northeast Asia. It's in the northwestern Pacific subduction zone, and this zone is seismically very active with abundant bedrock seas. And the global tomography shows that the subductive Pacific plate extends all the way to East China, and the matter about the subductive plate is very rich in minerals that is expected to promote a vigorous mantle convection. And in this area, the plate motion is very complicated with so many plates, including the Eurasian, Indian, and Pacific, and Philippine Sea, and Hotsk Sea plates. The Korean Peninsula is surrounded by three seas. We have the East Sea or Japan Sea between the Korean Peninsula and the Japan Arc, and the Yellow Sea between mainland China and Korean Peninsula, and East China Sea, and specifically, we call the very northern part of the East China Sea, the South Sea. The East Sea is comprised of a shallow continental shelf, steep slope, and deep, deep sea plains, whereas the Yellow Sea and South Seas are just the shelf sheets. So these seas have different tectonic evolution and age. Okay, I will briefly introduce first the tectonics of the East Sea. The East Sea was created by typical bedrock tectonics, which means that quite a long time ago, the Japan Arc was positioned very close to the Korean Peninsula, and it was separated to its present position. Interestingly, the Korean margin here is the place where the southwestern Japan Arc was separated, and we expect that this area registered the early history of bedrock rifting to spreading. And as is expected, the Korean margin preserves rift architecture consisting of the rift basin and objective rift bank and steep slope. Very perfectly. And if you look at the seismic profiles of the geologic structure here, we can see that the rift basins are flanked by objective footer blocks, and we can recognize erosion surface that is interpreted as the breakable conformity identifies the thin rift and post rift sedimentary units. So we can estimate from this breakable conformity that a breakable conformity occurred at the end of continental rifting, and it was followed by the seafloor spreading, that is bedrock spreading. So, we can say that the Korean margin experienced the entire sequence of tectonic events typical of a passive continental margins, even though it is located in a subduction zone or in a bed arc. This figure shows overall tectonic structure around the Korean Peninsula. So this is the shear wave velocity at the 70 kilometer depths computed from ambient noise tomography. And we can recognize low shear wave velocity anomalies along the continental margin. margins of the Korean Peninsula and the Japan Arc. So this low anomaly is interpreted as a waning ethnospheric radiance. Driven by convection about the subducting slab and involved in continental lifting and breakup. And the ethnospherical variance along the two continental margins suggest that the two margins are once a conjugate pair. That means the southwestern Japan arc was positioned very close to the Korean Peninsula, nearly in the north-south direction. And the significant clockwise rotation of southwestern Japan arc is envisaged during its separation from the Korean margin. This is a schematic model for the separation of the southwestern Japan arc from the Korean margin. So the back lifting initiated from northern, sequentially from northern to southern part in the late Oligocene, and from the late Oligocene to the early Miocene, the Japan arc rotated counterclockwise to its present rotation. And if we superpose the earthquakes occurring at the Korean margin on the structure map, we can say that the earthquakes occur on the structure created in association with backup lifting and breakup. And I'll move to the Yellow Sea. And analysis of the Yellow Sea consists of many sedimentary basins, and analysis of seismic profiles and drill core data in the southern part indicates that the lifting started in the early Cretaceous, followed by subsidence and uplift. And since the middle Miocene substance started approximately in the late Miocene, the seawater rushed in to form the seawater mass in the Yellow Sea. A key tectonic issue in the Yellow Sea is the location of the collision belt between the Sino Korean block and the South China block. In the late Permian or late Paleozoic and in the early Mesozoic times, the Sino Korean block and South China block collided along this very long orogenic belts amounting to the length is approximately 2,000 kilometers through the Dabi Sulu orogenic belt. And in China, scientists found some quartzite or lepidolite units that is typical of ultra-high metamorphic pressure rocks. And the presence of these rock units indicates that the continental crust of the South China block subducted to the depths of about 100 kilometers and then uplifted very rapidly. And many scientists think that the collision belt is expected to expected to extend to the middle part of the Korean Peninsula across the Yellow Sea, but in the Korean Peninsula we haven't found the ultra-high pressure metamorphic rocks. Instead, we found some high pressure metamorphic rocks. So we tentatively assume that it is a general consensus that the collision zone extends like this into the middle of the Korean Peninsula. And after the 2011 great earthquakes in Japan, we recorded small, medium-sized earthquakes in 2013 in the offshore, in the area offshore of the middle part of the Korean Peninsula with the magnitude of 5. the earthquake occurred in the region projected. In the region, we expect that the collision belt is crossing across the Yellow Sea. And at the location of the earthquake, instead of finding a fault structure, we just found a very interesting syncline structure here. If we think this syncline was created during the collision of the Sino-Korean block and the South China block, we can suggest that the collision zone extends to the Korean Peninsula. This is the coursing evidence. And the crust here, the basement rocks, were uplifted and exhumed after collision. And the magnitude 5 earthquake was the result of a fractional slip or strike slip or oblique slip on a blind thrust fault. We don't know yet. And we can figure out the overall tectonic structure of the Korean Peninsula from the results of ambient noise tomography computed at 30 kilometer depths and 70 kilometer depths. We can define a belt of low shear wave velocity here that is arced outward, and which might be suggest the location of the collision. And the continental crust is thin in the East China Sea surface. This was the result of backup extension, I think. And we can see the magmas coming from under the Philippine Sea plate extends to the northern part of the East China Sea. And this is, I think, responsible for the quaternary volcanic activity here. We have a small, medium-sized island, Jeju Island, the southwestern part of the Korean Peninsula. We have a very scenic volcanic features, the volcanic mountain with the crater on top, and the basaltic columns, and the lava tube cave. The present plate kinematics and stress field in North Asia is explained by the collision of the Indian plate with the Eurasian plate. And a scientist in Korea suggested that the stress field is oriented like a radial pen shape pattern. So, in and around the Korean Peninsula, the stress field is directed almost in the same direction, east, northeast to west, southwest here. And the analysis of geologic data suggests that the farthest part of the Eurasian plate was fragmented into a small microplate, which is called the Amurian plate. And the Amurian plate started moving on its own to the east, to the east since the Pliocene, approximately 6 or 5.5 million years ago. If we analyze the seismic profiles acquired from the southeastern continental shelf of the Korean Peninsula, we can suggest that this is the result of the cross-section reconstruction of seismic profile, and we can suggest that about 15 meters northwest to southeast compression started resulting from the collision of the Philippine Sea plate with the Japan arc. Then the direction of the stress changed abruptly to east to northeast to west southeast from 5.5 billion years ago. We think that the change in stress regime may have resulted from the eastward movement of the Amurian plate. And very recently, we have identified a quaternary fault system consisting of a main fault and an array of subsidiary medial faults. And the geometry of this fault system indicates that the maximum compressive stress is in the east, northeast, and southwest, south. So the stress direction agrees with the fan-shaped radial pattern of principal stress induced by the India-Eurasian collision. So I'll skip the summary, and actually I have not come up with any real proposal to do the seismic tectonic or geodynamic studies for the future, but I think I can use our newly established, newly built our ESAU as a source ship to investigate the crustal structure, because the geotectonic framework of North Korea is a challenging task, and the transition structure present in the sea areas are prone to tectonic activity. Fortunately, our new research vessel RV ESAU is equipped with the compressor with a capacity of about 1,800 cubic feet per minute. And this source would be enough to generate the compressed air for deep seismic sounding. So the Korea, China, Japan collaborative work can promote science to investigate the geotectonic or geodynamic studies in Northeast Asia. Thank you. This might explain the location of thickened continental crust resulting from the collision, I think. If this is the collision belt.
Why VS? Specifically, why is it VS, not other?
Shear velocity, VS.
Is it lower, Julius?
Yes, lower compared to the surrounding region. So that means the continental crust is thickened to a significant depth.
Are there any questions? No.